We gonna have to square things up around here. What's good, Power Director peeps? Today, I'm gonna show you how to make one-to-one aspect ratio videos for your Instagram feed and for other videos using Power Director 18. If you always wanted to make one-to-one ratio videos using Power Director, I want you to put hashtag Instagram feed in the comment section below. Here we are on the splash screen for Power Director 18. One-to-one aspect ratio videos or square videos are the perfect shape and size for Instagram and other social media sites. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to make square videos for your social media post. Let's box up some video. As you can see, there's an option on the splash screen which allows you to set your project's aspect ratio to 1:1. So we're going to go ahead and click on the 1:1. And then you want to click on full mode. Now, if you end up entering your project with a different aspect ratio, you can change it to whatever project aspect ratio you want right here. Just click on this little drop down, and you have all these different options for different aspect ratios as well as 360 video. So now you want to drag some of your clips into the timeline tracks that you want. So let's go ahead and drag these two in, and I'm going to stretch out the timeline here, give us a better view of these clips. So when we drag a clip to the timeline, the preview changes to a 1:1 aspect ratio. Keep in mind, when you preview an item in the media library, the preview window switches back to the previous aspect ratio of the original clip. So here you can see if I click on this, changed it to a different aspect ratio, 16:9. Same thing for the video. But if I go back to the timeline and I click on the clip, it'll change it to the project's aspect ratio, which is 1:1. Now, when you look at these clips, you see these horrendous black bars on the top and bottom of the clips, and we want to get rid of those. So for the picture, this is a picture here. We're going to left click on it to activate it. And then you have a crop icon, and you want to click on that. And then this opens the crop image tool. And you want to make sure that you're on the 1:1 aspect ratio. Click on that and then click on OK.
Voila, no more black bars.
Now we want to get rid of the black bars on the video clip. But before we do that, I want to remind you to subscribe to Power Director University to see great tips and tricks just like this every Saturday. If you decide to subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. And don't forget to follow PDU Tutorials on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for more Power Director love.
Now, let's get back to the breathtaking tutorial.
We got to take a different route to remove the black bars from the video clips. So you want to go ahead and left click on that clip. Then you want to go to Tools, Power Tools. And then you want to go to Crop Zoom Pan. Now, once you're here, you have the different aspect ratio options here. You can switch it up if you want to. If you decide that you want this one to be 16:9, you can do that here. I'm going to leave it on 1:1. And then what you want to do is you want to go ahead and scale this down, your width and your height, to go ahead and get rid of those black bars. You can also just type in the parameter that you want if you know where you want it to be. And then when you get that done and all of the black is gone, you can see in the preview there's no black. You can see around the nodes there's no black. Go ahead and click on OK. And then boom, in your preview you can see there's no black. So if we play these back, here's the image that we had, no black bars. Here is the video. No black bars, everything look beautiful, okay? But you're not done. You gotta produce your video so you can upload it to social media. So you wanna go ahead and click on the produce tab. Matter of fact, before we do that, let's go ahead and move these bad boys right next to each other. Now let's go ahead and click on the produce tab. And we're going to go ahead and produce a clip to save on our PC. So we're going to stay under standard 2D. and we're going to use the H.264 file format, and we're going to leave the file extension as MP4. And the profile type, we're going to leave on default. And here you can see that we have a MPEG 4. It's 480 by 480 is going to be the resolution. So that's a square. And my timeline is at 24p, so it's at 24 frames per second. You can change that. There are different options here if you want to go ahead and change it. I'm going to leave mine at 480 by 480. Then you want to go ahead and click on the location, the export folder where you want to export this to, so that you can find it on your computer. And I'm just going to put it in this folder, and the file name is produce. You can change the file name if you want to whatever you want to name it. Just type it in here. Then you click on save. After you're done with that, you go ahead and click on start, and it will create a video file in the location that you selected. Now you can choose to go back to the edit page, or you can open the file location to view the file that you created. So I'm going to click on open file location. And here's the file. It's called produce. When you double click on it, it'll go ahead and play the file for you. And now all you got to do is go to your favorite social media site. You could do whatever you need to do to get this file where it needs to be in order for you to upload it to Facebook or Instagram, Twitter, wherever you want to go ahead and upload it to. And that's how you make square videos for social media using PowerDirector 18. If you decide that you like PowerDirector 18 and you want to buy or upgrade to the software, I'll leave some links in the video description. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.